If you're itching to play a new Souls-like action RPG, then you probably want to check out how the game plays first. You may have already spotted our impressions for Lords of the Fallen on the channel already. So today we're going to take a closer look at the gameplay itself, because some of these encounters that we're going to show you look so awesome, with multiple classes to highlight and even some boss battles. For these first clips, we have the Assassin class going through some areas of the Lower Crane Port in the Axiom version of the world. To me, this is very reminiscent of the starting zones in Souls-like games before, with more simple mobs to take out as you get to grips with the combat and controls. And next up, we have an absolutely insane looking battle. It's a boss fight against a boss called Pieter. This one has different phases and honestly looks like such a spectacle to battle. You're probably going to need to get used to its different attack patterns to find the openings, and this will probably keep us on our toes when we actually fight it. Next is a bit of an introduction and exploration of the sanctuary area with the NPCs inside.
Welcome, Dark Crusader.
So the Exactors found himself a new instrument, as Exactors are wont to do. And given that lamp was intended for me, should his paladin fall. And yet now here you are, lamp bearer. Well, it seems I was right to doubt the value of a Dark Crusader's work.
Look at you. A Dark Crusader, a lamp bearer, and a revenant to boot. Aren't you the multifaceted one? Well, we Fidelis aren't as fortunate. We tend to stay dead when we die, and Aureus knows enough of us have done just that. Anyway, like Nathaniel says, you keep looking back, you don't see the blade coming at your front. We set ourselves a task, and we have to finish it.
And now we'll switch over to the Preacher class. There's some battling and exploration of various caves and cliffside areas. The Preacher class has some interesting combat because it mixes together hammer smashes, but also its magic. It's definitely a class to try if you like to mix in some magic with your gameplay. And here we can see the use of the lantern to switch into the Umbral Nightmare version of the world, where everything gets more difficult and enemies will keep spawning to keep the pressure on. Now we move over to the Soldier class, a more sword and board playstyle. And we'll be starting with another boss fight, this time it's the Boglord, a really giant, gross looking creature with massive sweep attacks, slams and moves. We aren't done yet with the Soldier class though, as now we have the Master of Hounds battle to show. A boss fight where you need to juggle dodging the ranged attacks of the boss and the melee attacks of the Hound. And now we have the Warwolf class exploring various cliffside areas and tunnels. This dual-wielding axe class has some pretty cool different attack animations and spins, but it does also make use of fire magic, which looks really visually good. And then here we get to see the use of the lantern again to switch into the Umbral world and explore a bit more. Okay. And next up, we have several different areas of the Umbral world, including a bunch of fights against a variety of mobs and even a boss-like fight against a really strong enemy. Thank you for watching, and the two videos on screen now, we think you'll really enjoy if you did enjoy this one. You don't have to watch them if you don't want to, but if you did like this video, you're probably going to like these ones too. And then tell us what you think after watching in the comments down below.